なんと初めてナポリタンパスタを食べてみたいと思います。はい、こんな感じになりました。
いただきます。いただきます。
You think we should slurp this? Like, I
never learned to do that. You can try.
No, but it's difficult without
so, the liquid. So.
They're good. What do you think?
Yeah, I didn't eat bucatini in a long time. It's good. It's nice.
We need a bit of olive oil. Do you need some as well? Sorry, I'm just gonna have a bit more. So, how are you finding it?
It's good. I like it. It's like not too weird, not so special either, I would say, but it's enjoyable. What do you think?
Yeah, let me just have a bit more.
Oh.
Come by!
Hi. I'm not trying this.
Yeah. Does it have something from Japan?
I don't know, because as I was telling you, I haven't really had pasta in Japan before. So yeah, usually I tend not to have pasta just abroad or while traveling.
Are there other type of pasta that they do in Japan other than Napolitan pasta?
A lot of people would know pasta alla carbonara, carbonara pasta, and also alla arrabbiata.
I think it's a bit different if you have sausages in it, right?
Yeah.
It's like not very typical here, but it actually matches.
Yeah, I think it would be interesting to try it in Japan and see whether we did anything wrong.
Yeah. Also, maybe the ingredients will be different, like the mushrooms.
Oh, yeah!
You
know? I didn't get any mushrooms.
Yeah, it's there.
Oh, there's a mushroom?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
What did you thought it was?
I think it was fat. And the sausages. Yeah, I mean, this is also a good season to have it, I guess.
Yeah.
Like this type of pasta you can have anytime.
Yeah.
And now right. With the cherry blossoms.
Yeah.
It even matches.
With the cherry blossoms.
Yeah. I have plenty in row now. What? What are you thinking of the park for the cherry blossoms? Oh, I really want to go there.
Yeah, there is a lake. Like,
yeah.
There's a lot of cherry blossoms.
Is that your bachata teacher? It's just like she dances with this really funny, a really funny teacher.
Yeah, I'm having these bachata classes, and she told me like every time she brings me to a different place because we do outside classes because of COVID. And next time we're gonna go to this lake, which is famous for cherry blossoms. Is it funny?
Yeah, I don't know. It's just like I associate cherry blossoms with Japan. It's kind of funny to talk about cherry blossoms in Italy.
Well, I mean, there are a lot of cherry trees.
Yeah, like here in Rome, I was surprised how many there are.
Maybe there is not a culture of like looking at them, like valorizing them, but they are here.
I teach you one Japanese word. Hanami.
Okay.
It means, as you just said, to go and have a picnic under the cherry blossoms.
It doesn't say.
Why are you laughing? Did you know it?
No, what's the word?
Hanami. Niru. To look.
Okay.
So it's basically to look at the flowers, but it became known as. It basically now means to. Look at the cherry blossoms.
Okay.
They are very, typical. in Japan.
Nice. Yeah.
And then obviously, like, people go and have picnics.
Yeah.
Friends with companies.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Meet. So, that's fun.
I'm quite full actually.
Yeah, it's like not easy pasta to eat.
It's quite filling.
It has a lot of ingredients.
Yeah, it's quite filling. But did you go chiso sama desu? Oh, you have any more?
Yes.
Okay, okay.
はい、皆さんごちそうさまでした。改めて感想を日本語で言わせていただきたいんですけれども、ナポリタンパスタって、まあ、本当にもう普通に単純に美味しいパスタとしか思えないんですね。もう本当に美味しくいただきましたし、で、そうですね、なんか多分名前だけが不思議というか面白いですね。だから名前以外は不思議に思ったことは特になくて、もう普通に美味しいパスタでした。多分、まあ、イタリアで改めてソーセージをパスタもパプリカと一緒に食べることはあまりないので、コンビネーション自体が面白かったんですけれども、もしこれって、まあ、ナポリタンパスタと呼ぶ、まあ、というふうに呼ばれていると言われていなかったとしたら、食べさせられたとしたら、これは何ですかというふうに聞かれたら、まあそうですね、ソーセージがついたパプリカとトマトソースのパスタ、まあ、というふうに答えたのかなと思います。だからそうですね、普通に不思議な材料もあんまりなかったし、全部美味しかったんですけれども、もしかするとこの同じパスタをまた日本で売っている材料で作ったとしたら違う感想が出てくるのかなと思いますので、今度は、ね、日本で暮らしている時にまた食べて、まあ、作ってかも、多分日本だったら、まあ、レストランとかでもやってるのかなと思いますので、はい、日本で皆さんが作ってるナポリタンパスタもイタリア人として食べてみたいと思います。はい、皆さん、ではこの動画が参考になっていただけたら幸いです。また日本でもナポリタンパスタを食べるのを楽しみにしてお待ちしますね。はい、では次回の動画までまたね。チャオチャオ。この動画良かったねって思っていただけたら、チャンネル登録をよろしくお願いいたします。